Hello there, this is Hans Forschner with Navcon Engineering. A quick video on calculating alarm systems or PA systems or early warning systems or public announcement systems. So the challenge with those models is that most standards are really not geared towards those projects. From a noise control standpoint, we rather overpredict than underpredict. These models that we have for the design of alarm systems are actually just the opposite. We want to rather underpredict than overpredict. And underprediction, of course, means that we are actually looking at other periods of the day that are the worst case. So worst case from an alarm system design is actually a daytime. So clear skies and a lot of sun, no wind. We have a lapse condition, which typically is inhibiting the propagation of sound. For the most part, ISO 9613 is modeling with the opposite inversion condition, which is conducive to the sound propagation. So ISO 9613-2 is not necessarily the best standard to design a public announcement system, because it actually rather overpredicts and underpredicts. And again, the challenge with these alarm systems are the daytime, where the sound may not be carried away or carried far enough so that you have communities that may be in dead spots because the sound just doesn't carry in those areas. So you'll see in a second where there are several standards where you can actually model more conservatively for these alarm systems by considering weather conditions that are not conducive to sound propagation. So in terms of the model input, I want to just go into the geodatabase here, show you a few input. Here's like a base model of a tank farm or some sort of a plant area. Let me turn on the a Google Map image. So this is like a plant, and for evacuation purposes, the owner of the plant wants to make sure that if they put in sirens that they are audible everywhere, and if there is any upset in terms of the plant operation, workers or people that do construction are informed that there is a situation and that they can go to whatever evacuation area. So here we have the geometry from Google Earth. So let me turn that off. We have buildings in here that of course can be shielding some of the sound propagation, reflecting some of the sound from the sirens. And then we also have the siren location, that's these dots on these poles. So we have different siren locations, and then we have a ground definition for the entire area, and also a calculation area. So this green line is the calculation area. The Turkish line on the outside, that's a ground definition. So let me open that up. So the ground was defined with a fairly reflective ground, ground factor of 0.25. If we do a NOT 2000 calculation, it's equivalent to a soft ground. Actually, this is not true. That would be by maybe a more compacted ground. Actually, the soft ground would be the more conservative, so I'll leave it at soft ground, sorry. All right. And so let me open up one of these sirens here. So this is a cluster of three sirens, siren 1, 2, and 3. And let me open up siren number 11, and the height is 50 feet above ground, so 15.24 meters. We have a certain directivity assigned, some power level assigned to that. And here we have a directivity. So there's a directivity assigned to the source. And here we can change and make rotate the siren to point in whatever location or direction. Here in degrees, so this is a horizontal rotation, a vertical, so up and down. And then our azimuth, and then here we also have a roll rotation that we can use. So you do that for the different siren locations, and that would be pretty much the model. Maybe one thing to note here, we can group each of these sources. So if you want to group them in clusters by adding a group, so this could be group one, and then assign that for, that's the next one, also group one, the third one, group one. Okay, then the next siren is, this is siren two, so we'll make it a group two. So with that, we can group and again, save the data also, not in terms of just individual sirens, but also in terms of the different groups. All right, let me save this down. In terms of the basically organization of this project, we have different layers. So let me change the view to current geofile. So here is all the layer with the calculation area, the ground definition, that's the terrain data, the buildings, and we have the sirens. Also, this is a system A, so there might be other configuration of sirens. And then here's the topo data, the spot elevations. All right, so let me close this and go into the calculation. And in the calculation, there's lots of different ways of calculating or predicting that. So here we have the ground model, or digital ground calculation. Here we have a test run for the single receiver siren at 100 feet to confirm that we are getting 121 dBc at 100 feet. And then here we have all kinds of different calculations. Each of these lines is defining a calculation type, like grid noise map, meshed grid noise maps. And here we have grid noise map A-weighted, C-weighted, just siren 1. Here A and C-weighted siren 2, siren 3, siren 4, and so on. And then also we have some calculation with different wind direction or wind speeds. So here is a NOT 2000 calculation. So the text for the title. And let me just show you in terms of the standard what we can do there. On the environment, here are the different kind of conditions that we can model, and the condition in this case is a condition with a west wind, with 6 miles per hour wind, with a slight lapse condition. So here we have a slight temperature gradient, negative temperature gradient, which means from the warmer air close to the ground, the air is actually cooling down with elevation. For every meter, we're going up by 0.02 degrees Kelvin. So that means we're going up 2 degrees Fahrenheit every 50 meters. And so with that, we have like a slight lapse condition. Okay, and then we have also in this case a grid calculation. So we define the grid spacing and all the other parameters for the grid calculation. Here, maybe just one thing to note. Let me just change this and recalculate that. We can save the data by groups. So that means we entered a group calculation, a group, we assign groups to the different sirens. So the program will now not only save away the overall predicted level, but it will also save away the contribution for each group by itself. So that means we can later on look at each group contribution by itself, and we can see the impact of just Siren 1, just Siren 2, Siren 3, or Group 1, Group 2, and so on. Okay, so let me just run this one model here. So I'll go into graphics, I run it. So there's the meshing, the ground model. Let me auto scale. And then so here we have our results. All right. Finally, I want to show a quick overview on the graphics part. And here we have all the input information. So here we can see each of the sirens based on the aerial view in the background. Let me just change one thing in the properties here. And I want to change the text. Okay. So here we'll add some text background here to the text. So here it basically shows for every siren the orientation and rotation of every siren to document kind of what's in the model. All right. Then here we have the siren level A-weighted. So we have all siren contribution all added up. Then we have another calculation, it's called Lmax. So the big difference is that we are not automatically adding up the siren. So it's always for every receiver, we only look at the contribution of the loudest siren. So it's not an additive that we have all four sirens added together. We're basically just looking at the loudest of each siren. Then here we have a weighted contour map, and so again here we have our total of six sirens, and then here we have a weighted, and here we have a C weighted. So basically same geometry, just using a different assessment of frequency weighting during the calculation. So it's load the data and then does either A weighting or C weighting or linear weighting. So this is again DBC. And then here we have the siren one. So this is only looking at one of the sirens. So the model with just the siren one contours. So here we can add siren two. Of course, this is pointing to the west. Siren three. And siren 4. All right. Last but not least, a quick other view, like a 3D view and a cross-section view. So this could be used to kind of visualize how the noise propagates on the horizontal plane, but then also in the vertical plane. So here we can see the cross-section a map from this is siren 1 and I think 6 here, and you can see kind of how the contours are bulging out in the direction of the siren orientation. And so that's also another way of presenting the data to your client to visualize how the sound is propagating within the plant. Thank you for listening. Have a good day.